As a cook and a meat eater, I've always been interested in big game hunting. Well, as the title says, I don't know a dang thing about it. So I decided to load up my old van, leave at the break of dawn, and drive down to northern Arizona to link up with an old friend, see if I could help him out. Late season Arizona Bull Elk Archery Hunt. Drove down through the snows of Utah, winds of Idaho. Soon enough, came to the painted cliffs, sunny skies, northern Arizona.
When we set out from camp the first morning, it was about 5 degrees Fahrenheit with about 20 degree wind speeds. So old Johnny got behind the glass, and I'll tell you what, if he didn't see some elk within the first 5 minutes, well, and I don't have a nose. Didn't see no bulls in there, so we had to get ourselves a better vantage point, and we set out to get a better lay of the land.
What the sun giveth, the wind taketh. It's gorgeous up here, but boy, I'll tell you what, that wind is ripping. Sun is just beating down on the guys right now, and it's going to be about 15 degrees in 30 minutes, but right now we are in the high desert, no doubt about it, huffing and puffing and getting a sunburn. That's why you come out. Here we go.
After several early mornings and late nights glassing and stalking, freezing our butts off and enjoying the beautiful scenery, we were excited to be joined by our friend Brian, his herd of 4 horses from Scottsdale, Arizona. First, we had to get ready for them.
Well, here we are back in balmy Flagstaff, Arizona. Got a new trailer. What's happening here? Why are we not hunting for elk there outside, John?
Well, you know, we had to take a little breather from this morning. We got in on a good stock, got about 85 yards from a big bull we glassed up this morning. Wind wasn't in our favor, but, you know, good location. Now we are grabbing the infrastructure for the horses that are coming in tomorrow.
Say there, John, what is it about doing fence that's just so darn invigorating?
Nothing.
Nothing at all, huh?
Nothing.
Jeez. So if one were to say that you're doing fence that you ain't for hire?
Frankly, I wouldn't conspire.
Do that anyhow. I'm right there with you. But we need a fence. Fences is what we do.
After a long afternoon of doing fence and getting water and spreading alfalfa, our buddy Brian finally showed up with the horses. And man, were we fast friends. They didn't mind a little drink in the morning, and it sure was a pleasure riding them. They took us right up into those hills where we thought we could get on some elk. And I just had a heck of a time getting to learn how to ride my horse, Reno. We got along like 2 peas in a pod.
Here we are, horseback today. Not doing as much glassing. We're kind of going up into these little fingers into the mountains. Pretty strong breeze. So we're just gonna see if we can find some good trail, find some good sign. Maybe try to get John on the right side of the wind and see what happens. But hey, another blast. Me and my buddy Reno, we're hanging out. We're having a good time. He likes to go fast. I like to go fast. So let's keep it up. Reno! That boy, Reno. Yeah.
You know, they say, if you don't like the weather, wait 20 minutes. Here we are. It was sunny about 20 minutes ago. Now it is snowing. Glassing visibility has certainly gone down. And we're going to make a new plan for the evening. We'll see. It might just involve some whiskey, hot toddies, care for the horses, hang out. Who knows what could happen?
Who knows what can happen is right. That little dusting of snow gave John all the track he needed. And in the morning, he glassed up a big one. He told me, hang out at camp and keep those horses ready.
Can anybody at camp hear me?
Roger that. This is camp over.
Yeah, I'm going to need you to hook up the horse trailer and head on down to that forest road you dropped me off at.
Woo! Bowl down, baby! On our way.
Big boy right there. Wow. Epic.
And this color, man. It's odd. It's so light. They're not usually that color.
The next time, you better be ready for a cornhole.
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, normally the front shoulder is pretty small, but I'm like, no, this one's not very small.
Oh my god, right in like the back of the gooch. That would hurt like a motherfucker.
Punch him.
Matt picked up a number of good lessons from my buddy outside John on this trip, namely the powers of patience and observation while on a hunt. But I was truly impressed by his respect for the animal that he harvested. And after a few minutes recognizing and somberly reflecting on what had just occurred, we got right down to work, getting every last bit of meat that we could out of that beautiful, magnificent bull. So we loaded up them horses, and I'll tell you what, they weren't too happy about it. But we got them out of there just in the nick of time, pitch black, led them on back to the truck. And I don't know why they were complaining there, because old Johnny, he, I think, had the heaviest load out of all.
This broadhead coming in at a quartering away angle. Right there, all the way into that bow.
That's the heart of the elk right there.
Dropped pretty quick.
Good shot.
To see what we're looking for right there. Yeah. There you are. Doesn't really get too much pressure, does it?
Nope.
So long. See you next year.
Once the horses had gone home and we'd packed up the corral, all I was left to do was put the meat in the freezer and go skiing, so to speak. So I headed on in there to the kitchen and we took to setting that meat out to age. After that, we sliced us off some of that backstrap and we had ourselves one of them real good times.
Child, name me, name me. They ought to take a rope and hang me. High from the hottest tree. Woman, would you weep for me? One more time.
Late night. Hell yeah.